This is the first tutorial of a series of tutorials. Please watch them all to understand the basics of a portfolio. To create a new A portfolio, click the Create button on your homepage. If this is your first time signing onto A portfolio, you may need to accept the A portfolio terms of use. You will need to give your A portfolio a unique title. If you are using a portfolio as part of a course, your name and a portion of the course title can help your professor distinguish between student portfolios. You will now need to choose a template. Ask your instructor if they have created a template specifically for the course. If your course has a template, you can select it here. Note that templates are listed alphabetically. Once you have selected a template, you can preview it. When you are done, click the X here. Once you have selected your template, click Create. This is the landing page of your A portfolio. The navigation menu is here. The navigation menu is used to organize, name, and add pages to your A portfolio. To edit the navigation menu, click on the white space to the right of your menu items. Then click the lock icon. Hover over the menu and a suite of editing icons will pop up. To close the navigation editing, click off the navigation section. You will see the lock slide closed. You are currently seeing the home page. Pages are made up of slides and content. Similar to a PowerPoint, you have a blank slide on which you add your text, images, content, etc. The section outlined in blue here is called the slide content area. This is where you will place text and other content, such as images or PDFs. To add content, click on the blue plus button here. Behind the slide content and to the side of the content, you can see your slide background. To change the background of your slide, click this gear icon. Backgrounds can include color or pictures. Slides stack vertically, and you can add numerous slides to a page. For simplicity's sake, we suggest no more than 2 slides per page. If you need to edit your navigation menu, click on the white space in the menu. This will bring up a notice that you are interacting with the header slide. Next, you will need to unlock the header by clicking on the lock icon. You will see a notice saying all changes made to the slide will be visible on all pages. To edit navigation, hover over the menu and click the Edit button. Here you will find all of the pages and subpages you have created. To add a new page, click Add a New Page and give it a title. If you need to move a page, click on the icon to the left of the page, drag and drop. If you would like to designate a page as a subpage, click on the icon and drag the page to the right. To edit the title of a page, click on the title. After you're done, there is no need to hit Enter unless you need to create another new page. If you need to delete pages, click the trash icon. Once you are done, click Save. If you have deleted pages, you will receive a prompt that will require you to type delete. You must type delete in all lowercase. To edit the design of your navigation menu, hover over the menu and click the design icon. Click this icon. You can choose a font and a font size here. The link section allows you to change the color of the menu link and the color the link changes to when hovered over. You can also choose to underline the links. The padding adjusts the space around your navigation menu. The background color section here is the closest color around your navigation menu. Currently, you cannot change the color of the navigation menu itself. Once you choose a color here, You can also adjust the opacity as well. You can add an image to that section here. If you want to edit the background of the navigation menu, hover over the menu and click this design icon. The section should look very familiar. Click the slide content to change the area around your content. You can change the color, image, or opacity. You can change the background in the slide background area. Again, you can change the color or add an image. To add content, click the blue button here. Make sure that you do not see this warning at the top of your page before adding content. This results in adding content to the header, and you will see that content on every page. If you do see this warning, click on the slide under the header. This is the content suite. You can see there are many options available to you in terms of how you would like to upload content. You may see this section. If you do, we do not suggest choosing a template from this section. Choosing a template here will add unwanted pages to your aportfolio. Most likely, one of the first types of content you will need to add to your aportfolio is text. You can do this by clicking on the rich text icon. You can add text directly onto your slide. Your changes will be automatically saved. However, you do need to publish pages before your audience can view them. If you need to add a photo to your slide, you have many options depending on where the photo is saved. You can upload a file from your computer. You can also upload directly from Gmail, Google Drive, and Google Photos. You can upload a PDF or Word file in much the same way. You can also drag content directly from your desktop onto your aportfolio slide. Adding a new slide is generally not necessary unless you plan to add multiple images to the page that need to be in a specific order. In this case, add a slide by choosing this option here. When you have a blank slide in your aportfolio, you can choose to add content to it here. To edit any of your content, hover over the content you would like to edit. You can see this suite of icons. The edit icon is the pencil icon here. For rich text, I can type more or add some very simple styles. If I highlight, it brings up a small style box. Here I can designate text as a paragraph or a header. I can also make a bulleted list, a numbered list, add bold, italics, or underline. I can also add a link or separate text as a quote. Clicking on the edit icon on PDFs, photos, or other content will allow you to upload different content. It's quite simple to move content around your Aportfolio page. First, hover over the content you would like to move. Click the Move icon. Next, drag your content where you would like it to be. You may notice some lines on your page as you move your content. These are guidelines that can help you line up content. If you need to adjust the size of content to fit somewhere better, click on a white circle in the corner of your content. Drag the arrow until your content is the size you would like. You will see the guidelines here to help as well.